It's day seven of the week-long swimming competition at Chengdu 2021 FISU World University Games as we welcome you to the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Aquatic Centre for the very last medal session. The women's 50-metre freestyle final is where we start this last session of the swimming competition of Chengdu 2021. Lakintana Skotov-Fitkovic, Zhang Gallagher, Antonio Huang, Te Gonzalo. Good reaction time from lane three. Fitkovic getting away really well. She was quick, so too was Zhang Yufei. Great reactions. Zhang Yufei already into her stroke, and she's leading. Erin Gallagher's trying to hold on, going in lane four alongside her. Those two looking to open up a little bit of a gap. Fitkovic looks good going in lane three. A powerful stroke, intense stroke as well by Antonio, who's looking to make up ground. Zhang Yufei has got this race under control. She's going to win it. Who's going to touch second? It might be Gallagher beaten. She's just out-touched Antonio at the wall. FISU record time, 24-20. For Zhang Yufei. She's got 8 gold medals in 8 events at Chengdu 2021, and she still has a relay to come this session. FISU records, FISU champion in the pool in all 4 of her individual events. But a 4th successive loss to Zhang Gallagher gets another silver, 25.05, and Antonio out-touches Fitkovic at the wall, 25.14 for Antonio of Cyprus. She gets her second. Kalia Antonio with her second bronze medal at Chengdu 2021. Erin Gallagher with her 4th silver medal of Chengdu 2021. But with her 8th gold medal at Chengdu 2021 is Zhang Yufei, the champion in the women's 50 free. Now to the men's 50-meter freestyle final. This is a race in which the swimmers are so close in time that a bad reaction time off the blocks will leave you out of the medals. A good one could guarantee one. This is edge of your seat action. It's the splash and dash. It's the men's 50-meter freestyle final. Wang, Ludwitzak, Spajari, Izzo, Peixoto, Keblis, Armbruster and Mizohata. Getting away quickly, the Brazilians, but the underwater is exceptional for Armbruster going in 7. He's come up nicely, but once he's broken water, Izzo is in front. Izzo is leading, coming up to the 25-meter mark, and he's powering in his stroke. A very accomplished stroke. Alongside him, though, is Peixoto. Peixoto's looking to be left behind. So, too, is Spajari. It's going to be Izzo in lane 4. Comes to the wall, but watch the wide lanes. Mizohata might come in. No, it is Izzo ahead of Martins with Keblis. A great finish from Martins Peixoto. Keblis holds on to claim another Lithuanian medal in the pool at Chengdu. 22.17, a big new PB. What a swim from the accomplished Italian. Peixoto finishes second to grab his third medal of these games. And Keblis on the podium. Jokubas Keblis with a bronze medal. Silver goes to Lucas Martins Peixoto, and a fine gold medal for Giovanni Izzo. The women's 50-meter breaststroke final is next. Titarevkova's got the 100 and 200 titles and aiming for that breaststroke sweep. Tormam Corbett, Titarevkova, Standara Alves, Chelintseva, Stankovic, Miyasaka go off nicely, going in 4. Look at that start from Standara. What a great reaction time and using her underwater so well, quickly into a stroke. Titarevkova looks like she's just been left a little behind, but Titarevkova is making up for it in the stroke. She was warming up so hard with a great intensity, and she's swimming alongside Standara now. Corbett is trying to make up a little bit of ground, and Stankovic going in 7 is looking for a medal from 7, but finishing fast is Alves Conceição of Brazil, but going in 3, it looks like the sweep is on. Titarevkova is going to claim it ahead of Standara as Brazil's defending champion finishes 3rd. Alves de Conceição, a 31.11, but a 30.58 for Titarevkova, a new personal best and a remarkable sweep. The 50, 100 and 200 meter breaststroke titles belong to Katerina Titarevkova. That's an astonishing accomplishment. Smashes her personal best. Her 30.82 is now a 30.58. Bronze medal to the defending champion, Jennifer Alves de Conceição. Standara Dominika of Poland takes the silver, but Katerina Titarevkova has completed the sweep. After winning the 100 and 200 meter breaststroke titles, she's claimed the women's 50 meter breaststroke as well. Now to the women's 200 meter butterfly final. Atazi was the class act in the semi-finals. She paced herself so incredibly well in the opening 100. Only Crispino was within a second of Atazi's final 100, so keep your eyes on the center lanes. Van Berkom, Lee, Mizoguchi, Hatazi, Crispino, Sebastian, Avetan, Jing. Good reaction time from Hatazi. Looking to use the underwater, though, and getting into a stroke very quickly was Hatazi. That was an interesting tactic, not using the underwater. Her reaction time was exceptional. Got into a stroke really quickly. For Mizoguchi and Crispino used their underwater really well and have come out in front of Hatazi. If Crispino can hold on for a fast finish, she's got the gold secured. Sebastian ahead of Mizoguchi. 1, 2, and 3. Hatazi is trying. She's upping the tempo now, upping the stroke rate. She's upping the kick as well. The kick is so incredibly important. Keep the chin low and get those legs pumping. It's a great looking swim at the moment from Sebastian. Crispino as well is alongside her, and fading a little is Mizoguchi. Coming back at them in Hatazi. But it looks like Crispino and Sebastian are going for the gold medal here. Who's going to touch first on the stroke? It's Crispino ahead of Sebastian. Mizoguchi holds on for the bronze medal. 2:09:10, the winning time. Antonella Crispino adds to Italy's massive medal tally in the pool at Chengdu 2021. But Sebastian, so close to finding the gold. She's 0.02 of a second off gold, but she finishes in a fine silver medal position. Mizoguchi takes bronze, but the champion, Crispino of Italy. A fine bronze medal to Meiji University's Mizoguchi Chiho. But the gold medal separated from the silver medal by 0.02 of a second in the women's 200 fly. The winning time of 2:09:10 for the champion Antonella Crispino ahead of Hungary's Dalma Sebastian. This is the men's 400 meter individual medley final. Martelli, Kamikawa Wata, Daigle, Tabucci, Mattiazzi, Krusta Almeida, Rug and Zobel. This is the final of the men's 400 meter individual medley. The competitors start with a fly, then into backstroke, then into breaststroke, then into freestyle to end. They find themselves swimming four different strokes over 8 lengths of the pool, so 2 lengths of each stroke in the pool. Great reaction time from Tabuchi Kaito. Mattiazzi alongside him, though, but it is the man in 4 from Japan who is going strongest. So too is Kamikawa Wata, as expected. So Japan touch 1-2, 0.31 of a second separating them. Martelli is third overall. Now this is the fly leg. Then we go into backstroke, then we go into breaststroke and freestyle. And so often you will see the lead change hands in a medley race. That the 400 IM comes down to technical prowess and pacing as well. Unlike the sort of go-for-it approach of the 200 IM, or at least what it's become. In the 400 IM, the race is more arm-dominated, but the kick and back and breaststroke legs obviously vital. Tabuchi and Kamikawa Wata leading Martelli. Martelli's now over a second back. But it is the Japanese swimmers who remain in front. Kamikawa Wata just ahead of Tabuchi, but Mattiazzi has moved up into third. The turns so good from the Japanese swimmers as well. Give themselves a little in that underwater. Going nicely in one as well is Martelli, who's moved up brilliantly after the backstroke. So Mattiazzi, Martelli fourth. But Kamikawa Wata and Tabuchi are leading and hoping for a Japan 1-2. But into the breaststroke, and this is where things get interesting. Kamikawa Wata and Tabuchi battling. Daigle is trying to get back into a medal position at the moment, and Mattiazzi is holding on in lane 5. Kamikawa Wata coming up to the wall at 2 at the 250 mark, 2:39.70, 0.04 of a second ahead of Tabuchi. Mattiazzi now within half a second. We're going to come down to a glorious sprint in the last 100 freestyle. So Tabuchi, Mattiazzi, Kamikawa Wata. Can Japan make it 3-1? Or could they make it a 1-2? Mattiazzi currently sits between them and is looking to add to Italy's medal tally. Tabuchi seems to have this race under control. A good turn, though, will set him up nicely coming home in the final 50. He is the fastest in the field. 3:15.66 at the 300 mark, 3:46.32 at the 350 mark. Matiati is absolutely pushing, had a good turn off the wall. He's within a second. Kami Kawabata is holding on for a bronze as all the other swimmers around him are fading. Cruz is fading. Daigle is gone out of this race, but the battle for gold is still very much on. There must be some belief from Matiati. He is coming back beautifully at the Japanese swimmer who's looking to hold on, but Tabuchi Kaito has stamina and endurance and will get to the wall first. Tabuchi is the champion of the 400 IM ahead of Matiati, and Kami Kawabata secures a second podium place for Japan. That will be a glorious feeling for the champion, Tabuchi Kaito. Tabuchi Kaito, 4:15.12. Ahead of Pierre Matiazzi and Kami Kawabata A of Japan on the podium. In the men's 400 meter individual medley, a fine podium placing for Japan. Kami Kawabata with bronze, Tabuchi with gold, and a fine silver to Pierre Matiazzi of Italy. Now for the very last individual event of Chengdu 2021 in the pool, it is the women's 400 meter freestyle final. Lovely day for the Cesarano family, the twins, Noemi and Antonetta, race against one another. Getting away in the women's 400 meter freestyle very comfortably. Li Bingjie is looking to open up an advantage, and her underwater is very solid. Dunay Kusir goes off to a relatively quick start as well, as does Kershely of Hungary going in one, but Li is leading. Great reaction time off the starting blocks. Any sprinter would be proud of that. A 0.52 for Li Bingjie. Six gold in six events, but it's been so impressive for the swimmer from Hebei. After winning the 800 and 1,500 meters, Li Bingjie, one other thing to consider is that she's not only been racing for 2 weeks, this is her seventh event at Chengdu, and she's got one event to come, the women's 4x100 meter medley relay, in which she will swim the freestyle leg. It's a punishing schedule, but if there's a swimmer that knows how to take control of that, it is Li Bingjie. Kershely is still there. Antonetta Cesarano in the mix. Dunay Kutsir, what does she do in the closing 100? What has she got? Kershely is now a body length ahead of her, so too is Antonetta Cesarano. Li, out of Shanghai Jiao Tong University, representing her university with pride at the FISU World University Games. The second most successful athlete of the Games so far, on course for another gold in the pool here. She's not leading by a significant margin, but she's got the ability to just up the tempo with a little burst of speed, and indeed she's doing that now. The 6-beat kick rate ups the tempo, and she's able to switch so quickly into a higher gear. She's not going to be denied. She is going to come home and sweep the 1-5, the 800 and the 400 meter free. Li Bingjie is champion. Kershely takes a fine silver, and Cesarano Antonetta takes the bronze. Kutsir of South Africa, 4:13.41, but a 4:08.38. Comfortable swim, knew what she needed to do. It was about her position, not her time. Closing 100, she closed with a 30-second freestyle lap over that final 50. Li Bingjie, the champion, 4:08.38 ahead of Kershely, and Antonetta Cesarano takes third. Her twin sister, Noemi, finishes seventh in the final. An exceptional athlete is Li Bingjie, the gold medalist. She swept the distance events 400, 800 and 1,500 meters. Aina Kershely takes the fine silver, and Antonetta Cesarano with the bronze for Italy. Now for the final of the women's 4x100 meter medley relay. Republic of Korea, People's Republic of China, Italy, Japan, South Africa, Poland, United States of America and Hong Kong, China in this final. Getting underway in what is the very last event for women at Chengdu 2021. Great underwater from Poland. Going in lane six is Adela Piskorska. Very nicely for Poland. But it is Piskorska who looks to be tearing up the pool over the opening 50 metres. She holds it in the back leg. It's a great turn as well. Poland ahead of Japan, ahead of Hong Kong, China. So Toto Wong looking really strong for Hong Kong, China, going in lane 8. Making strides now are Japan through Shuno Yumi, who's coming back in the closing 15 metres here. And Japan might touch second at the wall. It's Poland, though, who lead ahead of Japan, ahead of Italy. So into the pool for People's Republic of China after Liu Yashin's lead-off leg, Zhu Leiju in for the breaststroke leg. And suddenly there's a little mix going on in the pool. It's still Poland out in front. They've got the very quick Paulina Pera to come in the fly leg, and then free will be by the champion Kornelia Fitkiewicz. So Poland, if they can hold on to this kind of advantage, are going to set themselves up very nicely to come home and be crowned champions. China are coming back through Zhu Leiju in lane 2. And then they've got Zhang Yufei, world champion, to come. Li Bingji, world relay champion. Somebody who is a quality 100 free swimmer. China are in the mix. They're 2.82 seconds off the mark. Zhang Yufei, looking for a 9th gold medal in 9 events, is in the pool and swimming fly. Paulina Pera leads, though, for Poland. She's got them in front in lane 6. And going very nicely in lane 4 are Japan. Hiroshita Natsuki leaving Italy behind. Japan touch behind China. But that lead has been eaten into by Zhang Yufei, who's going to come home quickly. Paulina Pera is still in front. This is going to come down to the final leg. Fitkiewicz is very quick over the 100. Zhang Yufei needs to put China into a position in which Li Bingji, known more for her freestyle distance swimming, can challenge against Kornelia Fitkiewicz. But Zhang Yufei is just imperious. She is peerless. She is remarkable. She is astonishing. And China are leading after 3 legs. Oh, my word. That 3 seconds she made up in that leg. China in front with 100 to go. Li Bingji, what does she have left in the tank? She has only just gone out of the pool in winning the women's 400-meter freestyle leg. Poland, through Kornelia Fitkiewicz, are second. Third at the moment look to be Japan, as Shio Matsumoto is in the pool. Being left behind are South Africa's Georgia Nell and Italy's Violetta Scotto Di Carlo. China are in front by 0.5 seconds at the moment ahead of Poland. This is an absolute thriller to finish the women's competition at Chengdu 2021. It's Kornelia Fitkiewicz with 25 metres to go, closing in on Li Bingji. Can she hold on in the final 15 metres now? Li Bingji with a little burst of pace. She's up to kick rate. And she's going to come to the wall. China are going to claim the gold just ahead of Poland. In a thriller, China take gold, Poland take second, and a very fine bronze for Japan. An exceptional swim from Zhang Yufei set China up stupendously. Poland were in front through 100 meters, through 200 meters, through 250. But Zhang Yufei, you cannot overstate how incredible she is. People's Republic of China, just off FISU record, 3:59.67, ahead of Poland in a thriller, with Italy taking the bronze from South Africa. In the women's 4x100 meter medley relay, it is People's Republic of China who remarkably claimed the gold medal ahead of Poland, who had a significant advantage at the halfway stage in the pool. Bronze shared by Japan and Italy. Now to the very last event of Chengdu 2021 in the pool. It is the men's 4x100 meter medley relay final. South Africa, Korea, Italy, Japan, Poland, China, Brazil, Switzerland. So getting away really well. Korea going in 2. As you might expect, the starts are quick from the Korean swimmers. Italy as well got away decently in 3. Going nicely in 4 is Matsuyama Riku at the moment for Japan, but they're very flat at the wall. It looks like in 3, Italy's Stefani is going to take the front, and indeed through 50, Stefani is in front for Italy ahead of China, with Japan currently in 3rd. Gorai is coming back in the final 50. So too is Wang Gukailai going for China, as Italy just pulled away through Stefani, a lead of nearly a second over China, Japan third at the moment. So into the water for the breaststroke leg goes the Chinese triple world champion in breaststroke events, Qin Hai Yang. And you would not bet against China leading at the 200 meter mark, courtesy of Qin's swim. But it is Italy in front at the moment, courtesy of Alessandro Pinzuti, taking over from Simone Stefani, as he will get to the wall at just about the same time as the Chinese swimmer Qin. Japan still in third at the moment, but being challenged by Poland as Kołosowski makes up a little bit of ground. So Kołosowski, the battle for bronze between Poland and Japan at the moment. The battle for gold is firmly between Italy and China at the moment. And Qin Hai Yang just upping the tempo ever so slightly. 15 meters to go now, and Qin Hai Yang is in front, as you would expect from the world champion. He's swimming in his fifth event and looking for five gold medals himself. China ahead of Italy at the halfway mark. A 153.23 for Italy, a 152.41 for China. So nearly a second in it. Japan still holding on to third at the moment, but Poland will come back strongly, courtesy of Jakub Majerski, who's in the pool now for the fly leg against Genki Terracado. While out in front, China are hitting the front very nicely as Chen Juner looks to prove a point again in the relay. He's extended the advantage over the Italian swimmer Cristian Ferraro, but Giovanni Izzo is to come. The fastest in the pool over 50 meters in the freestyle for Italy. If they can be within striking distance of the Chinese swimmers, they're certainly in to challenge for the gold medal. At the moment, though, it's been taken away by the Chinese swimmer Chen, who's going to come to the wall over a body length in front of the Italian. The battle for bronze continues to be an enthralling one. Japan and Poland, who's going to touch third? Japan just ahead of Poland, but China out in front by nearly 1.5 seconds over Italy. Into the pool for the final leg, Kraska goes up against Mizuhata in the battle for bronze. Lin Tao is in the pool for China, looking to hold on against the very fast Giovanni Izzo of Italy, gold medalist in the men's 53 this session. China ahead of Italy, but the gap is closing. China, can they hold on in the closing 25 odd meters now? Italy through Izzo, race to the wall. The battle for gold is going to be a very close one. The battle for bronze is going to be a very close one. It's Kraska against Mizuhata for the bronze. Poland and Japan. The battle for the gold, though, is China against Italy. It is going to be the host nation in FISU record time ahead of the Italians. 3:32.58, the FISU record that has stood since 2009 is gone. Poland take an exceptional bronze as they out-edge Japan in the closing stretch. What a swim by Jakub Kraska to make up ground on Mizuhata. But China, set up by the brilliance of Qin Hai Yang in the breaststroke leg, they did not look back as Chen Junhe extended that advantage and Lin Tao was able to hold on. Oh, Poland with a DQ. So Italy take the silver and Japan take the bronze. FISU record time for the champions, 3:32.58. People's Republic of China, the gold medalists, ahead of Italy, ahead of Japan, who take another fine bronze.